Key verification in iMessage has finally arrived today in the latest iOS 17.2 update. A year after it was announced, this feature promises to drastically improve the security of your iMessages through two technologies, key transparency and contact verification. In this video, I'm going to talk about why this added security matters, what these two new features actually do, and how you can opt into higher levels of security in iMessage on your phone right now. Securing messages in apps like iMessage, which use end-to-end encryption, involves public key cryptography. Basically, let's say you're messaging your friend Alice. Alice has two keys, one public key and one private key. But you can think of the public key more of a lockbox that you can put a message in, and the only way to open that lockbox and read the message later is to use the private key to open or decrypt it. So, how this generally works is Alice gives you her public key, and you use it to encrypt a message one way before you send the message back to her. She can then use her separate private key on her device to decrypt that message and read it, and she'll be the only person who can ever read that message. All of this is well and good until you consider, how do you get Alice's public key in the first place? Some applications take a peer-to-peer approach, where you ask Alice's device to send you her public key directly. This works well if Alice and everybody else you message has a device that's always online all of the time, but if the other person's device is off, or in airplane mode, or otherwise disconnected from the internet, this approach doesn't work super well. This is why many messengers, including Signal, Google RCS, WhatsApp, and yes, iMessage, take a different approach to exchanging these public keys. They use a central key server which distributes keys on everyone's behalf. Now, instead of asking your friend Alice for her public key directly, your phone asks Apple what Alice's public key is, and Apple responds with Alice's public key. On its face, this isn't a direct threat to your encryption. It doesn't matter that Apple knows Alice's public key, because the public key is just that, it's meant to be public, and it can't be used to decrypt messages that are sent to Alice at all. However, this is still a position of power that Apple has placed themselves in another way. The most notable threat is the possibility of Apple including additional public keys in their response, perhaps ones that are under Apple's or someone else's control rather than only your friend Alice's. Then when you send messages to Alice in the future after you receive that malicious response from Apple's key server, your friend Alice is no longer the only person who can decrypt that message. Maybe Apple or someone else can too. This threat is exactly what key verification in iMessage is aiming to address. The first way that Apple tries to solve this problem is through a technology called key transparency. The way that this works is similar to another technology called certificate transparency, which is already in widespread use for auditing security certificates in web browsers. The short explanation for key transparency is that Apple has created a verifiable ledger of public keys, which new data can only be appended to, but the existing data in the ledger can never be modified. This means that Apple can't sneakily add fake public keys for a person to that ledger and then remove them later before anyone notices. When you enable contact key verification in the Apple ID settings on your device, and then you send a message to your friend Alice, your phone will locally compare Alice's public keys that it received from Apple's key exchange server with what the public key transparency ledger says that Alice's public keys should be. This comparison ensures that the public keys that Apple's key exchange server sends you are no different than the public keys that they're sending to everybody else. Additionally, your phone will routinely monitor or audit that universal key transparency ledger for what it says about your own keys to make sure that the ledger only has the public keys that your device expects it to have. This automatic key verification through key transparency is a huge security improvement, but Apple is also releasing a second mechanism which provides even higher assurance than that. Manual contact key verification is this second mechanism, and it's something that users of high security messaging apps like Signal and Element are probably already familiar with. In this system, you now have the ability to manually compare verification codes with the person that you're communicating with, cutting Apple's servers, including that key transparency ledger, out of the verification process entirely. To do this, all you have to do is open the contact's profile in iMessage, and it'll display an 8-digit authentication code under the Advanced Message Security section, which you can compare with the other person in person, over the phone, or via any other out-of-band communication method that you'd like. This code acts as sort of a unique identifier of the public key for that person, and when you mark it as verified, a hash of that person's public key is linked to your friend's contact card on your device. If Apple's key exchange server ever sends you a different public key in the future, or the key changes from what's stored in your friend's contact card for any other reason, iMessage will display an error directly in the conversation transcript for you to investigate further. To take advantage of these security features with your contacts, both of you have to open your Apple ID settings in the Settings app and enable verification in iMessage under the Contact Key Verification section. I definitely recommend that you do so immediately and spread the word about this change as well. It adds a layer of security to your conversations with essentially no downside, so it's kind of a no-brainer for anyone using this service. I will say, some of the stuff in this video is oversimplified a little bit, but I hope you understand the basics of how this tech works and how it protects your data. If you were clever enough to think of a question like, well, what if Apple shows Alice and I different versions of that key transparency ledger altogether? While you were watching this video, and you're about to leave a comment asking me, then first of all, great job thinking of that possibility, and second of all, I would definitely recommend reading this post on Apple's security blog, which goes into greater detail about how threats like that are also prevented by this system. I'm going to leave a link to that in the video description. If you like this video, you should also check out my video on passkeys, which is another public key cryptographic system that's making its way towards your devices to secure your accounts even better than passwords do, or you should follow my podcast on TechLore's YouTube channel, where we cover privacy and security topics like this all the time. Thanks for watching.